How the fuck did you just pop out of nowhere?
Bullets are a nasty business. The silver slug deformed and shredded on impact.
I'm about to say, like, what the fuck? Are you just randomly sitting
there? He'll
be
okay, though.
With the shirt on everything.
He'll be okay?
His internal organs are positively riddled. If I don't extract every single scrap of silver,
that was a game,
he's liable to suffer
real life
long-term toxicosis.
You get blasted.
Easy there. Try not to move.
Then you got somebody just sticking shit on you. Oh my god.
Pigby.
God damn.
We can't keep meeting this way, old boy. I figured I'd be done before you were conscious. But there's little I can do for the pain.
Swinehart, how bad is it?
Well, not the worst I've seen, but damn near it. I must say, you're testing even my skills here.
Please, Bigby, don't move it. Doctor.
God damn.
Look, I'm a bit engaged saving his life at the moment. But if the fractured extremity concerns him that much, he can set it himself.
I thought it was like watching a movie. Oh my god, I have to fucking do this shit? God damn it, bro. What the fuck? Oh my god, can you stop not stare at it, please? Just imagine me doing this shit in real life, bro. Dog, I feel like a bitch. Dog, I feel like that right in my wrist right now. I really do, dead ass.
Not bad.
Like, fix it.
That'll do, I suppose.
Like,
he's lucky to be alive.
Spam X,
and he won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
Move the bone the way it is.
He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll listen to you.
Maybe he's broken.
I don't know.
That and in my shoulder.
Well,
both hurt.
There are limits to what even I can do.
You know, I can't hear you.
Quiet. Just relax. Excuse me, Miss White, but perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
I think I should stay, at least until he's out of the woods.
Believe me, Bigby couldn't be in better hands. And I need the space to work, so...
No,
stick around, all right? I don't know if I trust this guy.
Oh, please. I could do this with my optic nerve severed. We'll be down in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
All right, fuck off. Jackass.
Hey, Doc, how much longer?
Damn,
Colin,
the pig comes in.
Leave him be.
It's finished when it's finished.
Because I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin, you're not even supposed to be here right now.
Oh, really? Where am I supposed to be? I'm here to take care of my friend.
With what? Your hooves?
Could I get some quiet in here?
Yes, that would be helpful.
Sorry.
There. All done.
Great.
This isn't a habit you should keep to. Having visits with me. And, well, this time. This time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Uh-oh. Yeah, that's it. You're done.
Miss White, he'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
He knows what it means. It's just been
no
an
action
unusual
this chapter.
Couple of days.
I know, but please, don't give him the excuse. His body will eventually give out. Take care of him. Please.
I will. He'll need rest, I assume?
Sleep, mostly. Just keep watch, and make sure he doesn't get into further altercations.
I don't need a babysitter. I can look after myself.
Clearly. Anyways, guard against, as they say. Miss White? Sheriff? Colin.
Swiney?
So, how do you, feel?
It's Bigby, Snow. He'll be okay. Hell, I've seen him take worse.
Not as good as can be expected, I think.
So, not well, then.
I'm glad you're not dead. You stopped breathing, you know, when you passed out or died, I guess. It kind of scared the hell out of me. I've never seen you like that. And when Swinehart arrived, you know him, he's never worried. And even he thought you were...
You were really worried about me?
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong way.
Colin...
I'm just saying, I was worried about him is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
Well, I'll get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing? What's even happening out there? I mean, do you guys have like a plan or something? And who should I be asking? Should I be worried about the Crooked Man taking over? Or is Crane still the thing?
Snow's the boss. She'll know what's best for the community.
Thanks. The Crooked Man came out of the shadows for a reason. For him to attack us so blatantly like that. He either feels invincible or desperate.
Well, if those are my two options, I don't think I'd pick desperate.
What do you mean?
You traded Crane to save Bigby. I'm just saying, that's not exactly something you do when you're playing with house money.
So he called my bluff. It's not like I'm gonna let Bloody Mary just murder.
Yeah, thanks, Snow. For all that back there.
No problem.
Thanks? You're not pissed that Crane's flown the coop? Or that the Crooked Man thinks he's got Snow under his thumb?
We're all mad about it, Colin.
Yeah, of course I'm pissed.
Of course I'm pissed, but what's done is done.
Okay, okay.
All I care about right now is just what does the Crooked Man want out of this? I thought he was just a loan shark. But clearly, he's operating in other circles. It can't just be about Crane, right? Getting him out of town? Is this all about the murders? Crane can't be useful to him anymore. So what could this have to do with Faith and Lily? How long has this stuff been going on?
Crane was a puppet, and the Crooked Man worked the strings. This is all about control of Fabled Town.
But then what do prostitutes have to do with it? Lily? And Faith?
I don't know how it all works out yet, but...
Maybe Georgie, huh?
I know it does. Somehow.
The Crooked
just the boss of the place.
Declared war against us last night. At least that's what I thought when it happened. But now I see this war has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken. We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean? The right way.
What do you think I mean?
I don't know, but it suspiciously sounds like your way.
Look, I know things haven't gone great recently, but we're still doing our best.
That's not good enough. So, starting now, we do everything cut and dried, by the book, straight as an arrow.
Pure as driven snow.
I'm not saying I'm the arbiter of...
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen again.
We need monsters to fight monsters.
Colin, if I really believed that we needed him to lose his flippin' mind at a moment's notice...
We were under attack, Snow. What did you expect me to do?
There are degrees.
Degrees? I only ever do what's necessary.
Really? Well, if that's the case... Please explain to Colin why tearing Dumb's throat out was necessary.
Bro, you try to kill me.
You can't let up until the fight is finished. He was still a threat, and that's all there is to it.
Basically.
Sure. Look, Bigby, I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy. Everybody wants Bigby to smile and shave and take a shower now and then. Hell, I'm practically the president of the Bigby Don't Be Such a Dick Club.
Well, at least someone understands. Thanks, Colin.
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to let you do it, okay? It's just that now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect. And this situation has to end.
What situation?
All unglamored fables starting today have to go and stay at the farm.
Oh, give me a fucking break. Are you gonna let her talk to me like that?
It's been the rule for a reason, Colin. And Bigby knows it's for the best of the town.
That's not gonna happen.
Yes, it will.
No, it's an impossible rule to enforce, Snow. You really expect to round up every talking cat and raven in town?
Exactly.
There's not that many stragglers left. Except the one or two you make excuses for.
Looks like the pygmy's clamoring.
Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Oh, Buffkin, what is it?
That's fucked up, I swear.
Okay, I'll let him know. Thanks. Guess who's waiting in your office right now? Narissa.
Narissa?
That broad from the Puddin' and Pie?
Yes. Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you. What do you think that could be?
Bigby's got an admirer. You always do well with the, disenfranchised.
I don't know. I don't know, maybe the fire.
I haven't the slightest.
Okay. I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long taking
calls.
Manipulate
me, basically.
And I should probably change out of these clothes. Consider the discussion tabled, but not over. Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain. She's a piece of work. Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you?
Nah, you staying.
I mean,
I'll make you stay.
She seemed real serious about it, but I can still hang out here.
Look, maybe a few will get sent up, but you're my friend, Colin. I wouldn't do that to you. Don't worry
about
it.
What if Snow,
thanks,
Snow don't like me? Exactly. Lucky Pond, okay, episode 4, in Sheep's Clothing. So go to Lucky Pond and what's gonna do?
Hi.
Oh, the pen.
Sheriff.
That's it.
Hi, Narissa.
The Wolf Among Us.
Yeah. Have a seat.
Are you okay? You didn't look good last night. I wasn't sure you'd be, you know, around.
Well, let's just say I've been better.
Huff and Puffs. Not many people smoke those.
What, sure is? That's the Newport and that's the Marlboro, I guess. Yeah, what brings
Thanks.
You here?
So what is it you wanted to talk to me about? I know what you did for me, sending me to the open arms. And I think you want to help me again.
There's not a lot that I can talk about. You know that.
So that spell Crane was trying to break. It's not just while you're at work, huh?
What I mean is, I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want you wasting your own time either.
Back in the dressing room, at the Pudding and Pie, I told you what I was looking for, and you found a way to tell me. You sent me to the open arms. Maybe that'll work again.
You can try. I just... Go ahead. It might work.
Yeah.
You're here because the crooked man just sent Crane to the bottom of my list of worries. And you have something you want to say about that, right?
These lips are sealed.
Mm-hmm. That's what I thought.
If I could answer you just like that, I wouldn't have had to make that appointment with you.
No, I guess not.
Sometimes we have to find our way through life on our own, grasping and fumbling in the dark. I used to have friends to help me find my way, but now they're gone.
I'm gonna start doing that.
And I don't know what to do.
But if I don't want to answer the question, these lips are sealed. And you'd be like, what?
Is these this lips making any are sense? Sealed.
Oh, shit.
I'm not sure how I can...
Trying to say something about Faith and Lily?
What I'm saying is friends matter. And I...
Oh, you want
I
to
don't
be a
have
friend?
Any left.
Is that what you're trying to say?
So I hope you're looking after yours. Are you? Look around you.
I guess it's my job to look out for people.
I don't know, but
not just my friends.
I'm sorry.
It's not I
could do this.
I should have put triangle.
I need you to know I want to help, but...
But your lips are sealed.
Best choice. Best choice ever.
I'm
exactly
sorry
exactly
if
my
I'm
that's exactly my
time.
Quote now.
I thought I knew how to say it.
Ribbons. Faith wore one too.
Do you like it? Do you?
I guess.
It is beautiful. That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
Yeah, because they'll all be wearing it. I mean, take it out, and then the lips ain't gonna be sealed no more. They take the ribbon out. Is he gonna do it? Fuck it. Go ahead, let's go.
No! Lips are sealed!
Oh, exactly, exactly.
Just stay back. You
exactly.
can't.
That's what I thought.
Do that.
Slow down. It's all right. I'm not gonna do anything.
Please.
I guess if it's take out, she's
don't.
Dead. Maybe that's
okay.
Why Faith died.
I get it. So the ribbons, if you take them off.
Sorry. Just don't do that.
If anyone finds out I came here.
That's probably Snow.
Listen, Sheriff. Can you keep this conversation between us? I could be in a lot of trouble.
Nah,
I shouldn't be
Snow.
Talking to you.
I'm gonna have to tell Snow. She has to know about the ribbons.
If you have to, just don't tell anyone else.
Oh, you cheating on her?
Sorry,
oh.
I just need to talk to the sheriff for a moment. Please excuse us.
1 minute.
I might have a new lead for you, but I don't know how solid it is. Beauty and Beast called the office just now. They said they wanted to talk to you about something. I wonder if they've heard about Crane.
Thank you for listening, Sheriff. You should go on to your next business. I don't think you'll be wasting your time.
Wait, you don't have to go. That was... abrupt?
That's one way to send a message.
What did she tell you? I didn't mean to rush her out. Did you get anything from her?
She told me enough. I think she told both of us with the way she just left.
Okay, then. Good work.
So,
about Beauty and Beast, do you think there's something to it? Is this the right place to look? What could they know about the Crooked Man? Or do you think they just heard about last night, and they're scared about what's been going on?
Beauty told me she had to take out a loan from the Crooked Man. Seems like a pretty bad deal.
I can only imagine what they're thinking now. We need to solve this before something else happens. Who knows what? I have other matters to attend to.
Okay. Once upon a time.
And you didn't want to tell me what you were into either.
Good reason. Look what happened.
So that's back on me now. I thought we agreed that was settled.
You...
Oh. What do you want? Well, you're just going around knocking on doors? Stirring the pot.
Snow sent me. Said you wanted to talk.
Not me.
Listen, I've had a shitty night.
You think you're the only one?
And I really don't want to deal with the runaround. Snow said you called and wanted to talk to me.
Well, I didn't call. Must have been Beauty. She's been surprising me a lot lately.
Can I...
So have you, Bigby. Yet, with all the sneaking around and secrets, somehow I'm still the bad guy in this. I've had to hear about it all night long from her.
Who is it? Who's there?
If you don't want to talk, can you just get Beauty for me?
I don't know. Is it safe to turn my back? It's your pal, Bigby.
Hi, Bigby. Please excuse us for just a minute. Can I talk to you in private?
Yes, let's.
I guess I really do have the smallest apartment in the Woodlands.
I can already tell you're going to make a problem out of this.
What's he doing here? We don't need to bring him into this.
Beast.
I just don't think we can trust him. Not after the way he went behind my back. And then you run and call him again?
Talk about living in the past.
He was keeping secrets for you.
It was one little thing. Do you want to keep fighting about that? Or do you want to try to sort this out?
All I'm saying is we can handle this on our own. You didn't have to bring him here.
We're out of money. And answers.
Oh. Thanks for letting us finish our conversation.
Sorry, it's been a long night.
Yeah, you know what they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta say, your place, it looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
Beast!
No, really, I wanna know. What are you trying to say, huh?
Nothing. It's a nice place you got here.
Thanks, but that's really not why I called.
Is this something about that loan you took out? From the Crooked Man?
I didn't know what else to do, so...
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to complicate
things. I called him here, and I want to see if he can help us out. Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us.
I'd like to help you, but I can't do anything if you don't tell me what's going on.
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the Crooked Man? What if we talk and you don't get him? And all this comes back on us? We'd be risking a lot. We've seen what happens when you cross the Crooked Man. And I don't know if it's worth it.
I can protect you, but only if you tell me what I need to know. And that means details. No more stonewalling.
We aren't.
And just tell me what's going on here.
Look, we're used to a certain kind of lifestyle, okay? We couldn't just give that up.
We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn. And we got in over our heads.
There's not a lot of work out there. Who would we be if we just
you keep telling me. Working this is tough right now.
Hi there, you've reached Beauty.
And Beast.
And we're out doing something fabulous.
Let me just,
A day at the beach?
Skiing the slopes?
Can we finish this conversation first?
I should get that.
Leave a message at the beep and we'll get back to you as soon as... humanly possible.
Jesus Christ.
That fucking message. I'm gonna come down there and bash your heads in with that machine if I have to call again and hear that fucking message one more time. I've been doing this long enough to know that if you had the cash, you'd have paid by now. So consider yourselves out of warnings. It's time to start thinking about how else you can settle this.
Who is that?
It's Crooked Man.
The Crooked Man's gonna get his, one way or another.
All I care about is, how can I find the Crooked Man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The Crooked Man's behind that place. I'd overheard people talking to Jersey about loans before. So, when I needed money, that's where I went. I didn't know what to do.
Did you ever see the Crooked Man there? When you got your loan? Or just shopping?
No, never. But come on, it's his place. And the Jersey Devil never lets you forget it. I can see now that it was a mistake, but I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day. It was in a display case.
I guess he's hit hard times, too. There's a lot of that going around.
What the hell are you doing hanging out at a place like the Lucky Pawn anyway?
Sometimes fables sell things they brought from the homelands. Things you can't find anywhere else.
You do know there's a difference between pawning something and selling it, don't you?
I know that.
You're buying a piece of someone else's misery. With money you don't have.
Well, that's over now. Maybe if you go there you can... sort some things out.
I guess I'll go check out the Lucky Pawn. If I can't track down the Crooked Man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the Crooked Man will come find me.
Hold on, Bigby. Don't go there. Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble. And...
me.
You know that butcher shop, the cut above? It's the place on Tubman Street. Same block as the baker and the candlestick maker.
Oh, that's the same with Auntie.
Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the Crooked Man. And I don't think it's meat in the packages.
Well, what are you delivering? What's going on there? How does this fit into the Crooked Man's operation?
I couldn't tell you, but I do know this. It's the only meat market in town that doesn't carry filet. I'm not sure how much actual butchery goes on there.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the Butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me. She said I was reliable. She liked that. And it's the only thing I've been able to pick up, and it's still not enough. I don't want Beauty to have to work, especially not where she was.
So you do their dirty work and look the other way.
Work is work. All I do is deliver stuff.
Yeah, I feel you. I'll just be driving.
I just wanted to provide for Beauty. Give her the kind of life she deserves.
We shouldn't have to live like
this. Just a hard-working man.
Scraping to get by.
None of us should. We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle. All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home. You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
Yeah, with all this luxury stuff you'd be buying, goddamn.
No, probably not.
So, where are you going? If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from.
Alright, so going to Lucky Pond.
I'm going to the Lucky Pond. There's too much going on there to ignore. I'll have a word or two with Jersey.
You know, Bigby, once you show your face there, word is going to get out. There may be nothing left to see if you go to the butcher shop after.
Well, I guess I'll find out.
What's with the soundtrack? Wait, what the hell?
I don't know what you're planning to do when you find the Crooked Man, but is there like any the way you could help us out?
What do you mean?
Well, maybe you can make this all just go away.
Are we making
a
deal?
We really appreciate it. What do you say?
Can you help us out?
I'll handle it. I'm not gonna let that crooked bastard ruin any more lives.
Oh, thank you, Bigby.
I'm sure you'll do the right thing.
Mm-hmm. There was a wolf. There was a wolf.
It's dirty.
No, it's not.
It looks like you slept in it. In a pile of garbage.
Jack, why are you... I've seen you take a torn purse for a tenner.
Yeah, but I also got her phone number. I don't want your phone number. Ugh, really?
What?
Bigby's here.
Oh.
This is a surprise.
I'm just here for information. It's about the murders.
This'll take 2 minutes and I'll be out your way.
I'm not taking the coat.
But it's magic.
So?
And it'd be covering a check I already wrote.
Okay, well, that sounds like a your problem to me.
Yeah, it is. And so I came here to sell it off.
Why would you think I'd take an ugly, used mule skin coat?
Cause it's magic mule skin, that's why. And it's not even mule skin, it's donkey skin.
Oh, donkey
hey,
skin.
Wait a minute, that's Faith's coat.
It was Faith's coat. Look, you left it in my place. What do you expect me to do?
Yes, I think the off-sighted statute of Finders Keepers clearly states that it's his now, Bigby.
So what's it gonna be?
I don't know what to tell you. See if Cindy needs a coat. I don't know.
This is to pay for those bloody glamours, you know. You and your blinkered rules. If the witches didn't charge so fucking much, I wouldn't have to be in here dealing with this nonsense.
The witches set their own prices, Toad, and the prices aren't set because of greed. Getting a glamour is hard. The materials are rare.
Spare me the lesson in hoodoo economics. I don't want to hear it.
I don't know what you're getting so steamed about. Shouldn't be that big of a shock that I'm not gonna take an ass hair coat.
No, I guess it shouldn't be, since this whole bleeding operation's just a setup for one of his shady fucking loans.
Ixnay on the own lays, okay, Og Frey?
I mean, what kind of a game are you running here?
Toad?
You turn down people's stuff so you can peddle his shit.
I know who you're talking about.
Og Frey?
The Crooked Man, right? This is his place. Those are his loans.
Well, I'll leave you to your business. I'm sure you'll have a lot to talk about.
Good luck with that glamour, Toad.
Fuck off.
Leave the coat.
How the hell do you expect me to get a glamour then? It's not like I've got a lot of options, you know. It's just tough.
It's all fine. Take it. Get some use out of it. If you're gonna be out like this, can't you at least wear a bigger hat?
Have a good day.
Sounds like the middle finger.
Drop by anytime.
Fuck you too.
It really grows on you. Look, I told you I work here, and I do, okay? So don't look so surprised. And before you ask, I've never seen the Crooked Man in here. Neither hide nor hair and all that. In fact, as far as I can tell, he's never even actually stepped foot in here.
But Bloody Mary works for him, and the last time I saw her, she had the woodsman's axe.
So?
So the last time anybody else saw that axe, it was here.
We'd never take something like that. Is this really why you came down here? The woodsman's axe?
I'll be asking the questions here, Jack.
Okay, fine. Fire away. Because I'm not a mind reader. And unless it's bar trivia, I don't think I can help much anyway.
Do There's more than just pawning going on here. You got the loans. What else? Maybe it's like a weapons locker, too. Was the axe here?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. I think I'd notice a giant mystical axe. And that's saying something. Since, you know, I can sometimes miss the obvious.
And if I just happen to find a giant mystical axe?
That would be quite the magic trick. Listen, I gotta start closing up shop, so,
Close? It's the middle of the day.
What can I say? Jersey likes to run at odd hours. And really, he'd be the one to talk to, so, can't you just swing by later? It really wouldn't be good for me if he sees your face when he walks in, so,
I still think you're hiding something, Jack. Maybe the axe is back here.
It's not.
It was bad enough in the woodsman's hands. And if it's not here, I need to track down that psycho who had it last.
It's not here.
You better hope not.
Can't you
Shut up, Jack. If the Jersey Devil isn't here to answer my questions, it also means he isn't here to get in my way.
Dolph Ziggler.
So I'm gonna take a look around, as long as I've got the elbow room.
All right. Don't let me get in your way.
Dang, you're really close. Really. Alright, first things first. Go to there. Pincushion. I get that Book of Fable.
Reminds me of Briar Rose.
You're not touching anything, are you? Oh, okay then.
Alright. Okay, so I guess just look at anything. Suitcase. Oh.
This is Prince Lawrence's dagger. Who sold this?
I don't know. Look, are you almost done? A dagger isn't exactly the axe, so,
How can you not know who pawned it?
I'm not here every day. And even when I am here, people sometimes dump boxes of shit. What does it matter? You don't know how hard most of us have it, do you?
No, I know how it is.
It was a rhetorical question, but sure, fine.
Oh, it's the same Hitler statue.
Isn't this from Crane's apartment?
Maybe, I don't know.
You didn't go back over there and swipe it.
I swear, on Toad's life.
On Toad's life. They have recent acquisition. Uh-oh. Oh, there it is.
I thought you said you'd never take something like this.
What?
Jack?
Yeah?
When was the woodsman here?
Was who here?
The woodsman. Because the axe was here, but it's gone. Did he pawn it? He usually doesn't let that thing out of his sight.
I don't know anything about that. I don't, really. I mean, I don't work every day, so...
Just tell me the truth. What happened to the axe?
Well, it was Mary. She took it, okay? That's all I know.
That's all you know? You don't know she almost fucking killed me with it last night?
No. No. I had no goddamn idea.
Why'd she take it? Just to fuck with me?
You think I'm crazy enough to ask her that? I'm not sticking my foot in that lawnmower, thank you.
Well, for your sake, you better think of something to tell me.
That's all I can tell you. I'm being straight here. I'm just part-time. I mean, it's Jersey who's the one who's into this stuff. He's one of the Crooked Man's boys, okay? And it'd be great if he was here to tell you all this, but he's not. So just...
Jersey, don't give me that shit. What the fuck is the point of having a system if you're just gonna...
Not my fucking system.
But you... You're the guy who makes sure
that... I'm the guy who keeps shit in order. And that's it, Woody. Who closed the fucking gate? Jack? If you love your ex so fucking much, why'd you pawn it in the first fucking place?
I didn't pawn it, asshole. It was stolen from my apartment. And Grin said that he saw it here. Now tell me where it is right fucking now.
Woody, calm down. Your ex isn't here.
Christ. And this fucking guy, too?
Bigby? What? It isn't?
Nope, it isn't.
Just like I said, it's not here. Happy? And you, I can't believe you'd even show your face in here. After what you did to our guy, Tweedledum, So tell me what you're here for, or get the fuck out.
He wanted to know
what your fucking attitude.
If I were you, I'd watch my tone about now.
First time I know you, you already
How's
know my
your
face.
Aunt? Bloody Mary leaves a bit of a stink, don't she? Jack, did you know that as of this very morning, Bigby's joined the Crooked Man's Obedience School for wayward fucking creatures? He's already passed his first class. You see, the sheriff had who he stupidly thought was the murderer. Been chasing him for fucking days, right? But the Crooked Man snapped his bony fingers, and Bigby handed him over, just like that.
I'm, just gonna, let you two, you know.
Go fuck yourself, Jersey.
Are you kidding me? It was here. It was right fucking here. What did you do with it?
How the fuck do I know?
Listen, you bald little dipshit. You're gonna... You piece of shit.
I'm gonna train Jersey, fuck
rip
him.
Your fucking lungs out.
Jersey's a dick, isn't he?
Back at
Sign
him,
with
Jersey.
Woody.
You're dealing with me now.
I didn't expect to see you upright. Still looking for whoever killed them hookers? Or are you done chasing your tail?
Yo, where's punch my axe?
Punch
Who'd
his man,
give it to?
Alright, dude.
That's it? You talk big, but I don't think you got the stones to back it up. Still a little sore, are we? Why should Mary get all the fun? You ain't so tough. This ain't gonna go like... You... Motherfucker!
What the hell are you doing? This is my fucking fight.
Not now.
Dog, you got a lot of nerve.
Uh-oh. Okay. It's a monster group.
Protecting your friend. Too bad you couldn't protect those whores. Go on. Try to stop me.
Fucking stink.
Okay.
There she is.
Oh, I'm gonna say.
Try again?
You can't find a crooked man. No one can. There's no address, no place. He lives in the bends and forks of tree roots, behind the sun, in the shadows.
That's not good enough.
Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot. You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror. That fucking guy. Oh, mirror, mirror.
I can't use the magic mirror right now.
Oh no? Why not?
Because I just can't, that's why.
You don't know anything about anything, do you? What do you have? Nothing. That useless bitch Snow White in a broken fucking mirror.
Shut the fuck up.
Oh!
The next thing you say better be something useful.
It doesn't matter what you fucking do. You're not gonna get him. You wanna knock on his fucking door and see what happens? Fine. Crane had the mirror. Bloody Mary had Crane. So take your fucking Wrecking Crew act to the butcher shop.
The cut above. And if I can find the mirror piece there, I can find the Crooked Man.
That's her spot. That's where all the magic happens. Now leave me, so I can find some aspirin.
He ain't going anywhere.
Will Mary be there?
You want me to draw you a picture? I don't fucking know. You got what you want. Now get the fuck out of here. Hey, Sheriff.
Oh.
Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you could do to bring them back. And I don't know what they did, but I do know this.
Shut his ass up.
Yeah, shut the fuck up, will ya?
I was gonna talk shit if I didn't say anything. Sure.
Thanks. Shitty brand.
Fuck you.
You're welcome.
I'm not gonna lie. I was having trouble deciding which one of you to hit with this thing. Jersey was wrong, you know.
About what?
About those girls. There is something you can do about it. You can get the fucker who did it. Ain't that the plan?
Yeah, you're damn right it is.
All right, well, go do it then.
Hey, that's the trip track. So he's like right next to the trip track.
Hey, Woody.
Yeah?
You gonna be all right?
You know me.
Easy, you'll be all right. It's like get in the cab. This is ignoring his ass. Oh, is that the cab driver? That awkward dude. That man only had one dialogue and that was it. Who ruled the land? Butcher shop. Yeah, stop, because obviously you can't smoke in there.
He's got a whole lot of customers, or he doesn't have any. Right.
Pile expired like shit.
Not very appetizing. Frozen solid. Who'd want to eat this?
Oh. Get the package.
Bet that's what Beast was talking about. That logo looks familiar. I've seen this before at Antique Greenleaf's.
Uh-oh. Who's this?
Bigby Wolf? What happened to you?
I'm looking for a piece of the magic mirror.
That was scary.
What?
The magic mirror's missing shard. Where is it? Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
What? Bloody Mary? Magic mirror shard? What kind of place do you think this is?
Don't bullshit me.
Oh,
I'm not. What you're looking for, I think you'd be better off looking at the Lucky Pond. Yeah, or someplace like that. You know where it is, right? It's around the corner and a few blocks down.
I've been there. Didn't find what I was looking for. Had some words with Jersey, too.
Words? Anyway.
Oh, this was Jersey's
blood. If I'd have known you already looked at the Lucky Pond, I wouldn't have pointed you there.
Fuck,
I just figured anything worth a damn in Fable Town goes through Jersey's hands at some point. You know that. Believe me, I don't want to waste your time, Sheriff. And I certainly don't mean to offend.
Where's the magic mirror shard? Quit fucking around and tell me.
I'm not. I am not fucking around.
If you're lying to me, I'm gonna find out. Listen, Crane had the mirror. Mary had Crane. And she comes around here, right? If you're covering for her, I'm gonna have a problem with you. So you better think real hard about what you say next.
Sheriff, I... Did you hear that?
What?
Oh, I'm real sorry. Hold on. I just gotta go check on that. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
Butcher?
I just have to go see.
Let's go check it out. Fuck it. Oh.
Shit.
Tell me I gotta walk through this now.
I got it covered back here, Sheriff. I'll be right out.
Okay, good.
Just wait out front. I'll be right there. I've got a bit of a mess back here. Look, can you come back tomorrow, maybe?
Okay. No. I've had enough of this shit, Johan. Come on out.
Just wait in the front. I'll be right out. I'm sorry, Sheriff, but you're not supposed to be back here for safety purposes. Come on, damn it.
Such an innocent guy, you're acting pretty damn strange, Johan.
I don't know what to tell you. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. They're gonna kill me. Oh, God, she is gonna fucking kill me.
Uh-oh.
He's gonna get me killed.
Typhoon should have scared the shadow. Oh!
How you doing?
Please, Bigby. Please don't.
Bigby? What happened to Sheriff?
Please don't kill me, Sheriff. I don't want to die. Please. Please don't kill me.
If you don't talk, I might have to do just that. Is that what you want, Johan?
No. No, please. You don't have to do that. I'm dead. Either way, they said to me, Johan, you can keep your life and lose your shop, or lose both. What would you do? It was a simple choice to make in the moment. Easy, even when they got you on a hook in the deep freeze. But it's a hard one to live with.
They? Do you mean Mary? Bloody Mary?
This isn't my shop anymore. That crew took it from me a long time ago.
Crew?
Fuck. The Crooked Man's people. Jersey Devil, Dean Dumb, and that mental case, Bloody Mary. You want to talk about the real butcher? It's her, not me. This is her place. I'm telling you, they muscled in on me. Took over my storage and delivery a long time ago. All cause of that heat wave. That summer was even hotter than this one. Oh, I'd let Mary and those porkers stay cool in the meat locker one day, playing cards, having a great time. I guess they were sizing the place up. Shows what I get for being nice. I'm just a victim in this. I don't know what they do back there. I swear. And I don't want to know.
Well, we're about to see what's back there. And then we'll see if I believe you.
I knew this would happen. Didn't know when.
Shh. Is this place?
I told you, Bigby. I don't know. They muscled me out. I swear, I don't know anything more. I haven't been back here when it was like this.
Warning lights.
It's business. It's all I've ever had. I guess that's why I stuck around when they took it.
Damn it. You can't act like you're forced into this and then turn around and help them. Still be here if you hadn't flipped that switch out there.
I had to. Huh. You come in here making trouble for me, but you only give a shit now because the crooked man stepped on your toes or something. Where were you when they took this place from me?
Did you call?
It hasn't been easy for me. You think I want to live with this at my back? I needed help.
You're not off the fucking hook yet, Butcher. If I find something, I so much as smell something that makes me think you're lying. So this is what Beast was delivering. Glamours, other kinds of magic. Could be dangerous stuff. That symbol. It's on all the packages. What is it?
That's the Crooked Man's, brand. It's on everything that goes in and out of here.
So you do know something, huh? Is that a wheel or what?
I guess they never used that thing on wolves, huh?
What's that supposed to mean?
It's from back in the homelands. A torture device. It came over here with the rest of our stories. Not that Mundys need any help coming up with that kind of thing. It makes people crooked, by breaking their bones, and do I really need to explain this?
Too bad they had time to erase it all. This could have been useful.
Yes, yeah.
Maybe just...
No.
These are raw materials for making magic. Anti-Greenleaf and any other rogue witches out there probably get their supplies here. Getting chained up here.
You can't think I'm the only one the Crooked Man has under his yoke.
Is this what those loans get you? That crooked piece of shit. Ribbons, chains, it's all the fucking same. What the hell is that?
Looks like Beauty's shirt.
I know this isn't your coat. What's it doing here?
It's a coat. What's the big deal about some dirty...
Looks like Crane's. It's seen some abuse. I'm sure he handled it just fine. No time for traveler's checks, huh?
Fuck yeah.
He won't be needing this anymore. That sick piece of...
Oh, there you are.
It's the shard. Finally.
Hey, hold on. Well, I'm real happy you found what you're looking for, Bigby. But what about me?
I don't give a fuck. Fuck you.
What the hell am I supposed to do now? I'm gonna have to spend the rest of my short life looking over my shoulder for Bloody Mary.
Report to the business office. Tell Snow I sent you there, and we'll,
That's what I'm saying, tell
we'll
Snow.
Figure something out. Some kind of protection.
Thank you. Thank you, Sheriff.
Much feared.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes. If Crane was helping himself to the community coffers, it means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in. Now, Miss White,
I... Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss White.
You will have to wait. Just one moment, please.
Look what I found.
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
I'm not in the mood. And you've got a lot to answer for.
Oh, really?
Bufkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Finally, things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day. What did you uncover? I thought you were going to report back to me. I mean, it's fine. So what else did you find out?
Once the mirror's fixed, we can use it to find that crooked bastard. Or at least wherever he hangs his hat. That's how Crane kept tabs on him. And everybody else. I'd say he was abusing the privilege. He was probably spying on all of us.
He was probably spying on me.
Anyway...
No, it's fine. You did... Excellent work, Bigby.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Don't go far, Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
Unbelievable. Pompous ass.
Why don't you go fuck off until I'm good and ready?
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
Got me.
Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know.
I found it at the butcher shop, the cut above. It was in Crane's coat. There was a lot of weird magic going on there, if that has something to do with it. Other than that, the last person I saw with Crane or his coat was that psycho Bloody Mary. Maybe she had some...
Ah, yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help. It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Bufkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office so bad?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now. We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're over there bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
You need some help over there?
Yeah, thanks. go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him. He really needs to go to the farm, you know. So just break the news and be done with it, okay?
No budge on that bloody glamour. Only came in to see him. Toad, come here.
I thought I made myself very clear.
I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh? Why am I not surprised? Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is. Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallop because of you.
I'm starting to think you don't take me seriously, Toad. How many times have I told you to get glamored up? You know that if you're out of glamour, I gotta send you to the farm.
Well, how about your friend the pig, hmm? Is he going to the farm too? Yeah, you thought we didn't know about him, huh? A worst-kept secret in fable time.
Colin isn't your concern. You should worry about your own fucking situation, Toad.
Exactly, worry about your own situation. Everybody got their own
way
of breaking rules and do whatever they want.
If you give me one more chance and hear me out, I'll see a way for me and me boy to stay.
Trust me, I see that.
I'm not gonna ask for any more than I need. I just wanna stay. So what do you say? You just give me enough to cover me glamours and we'll call the rest to watch. Please, Sheriff, don't take TJ from the only home he knows. This old glamour rule is oppressive. I've done nothing wrong but look different.
Look, I'll try to get you that money and get you another chance, but you have to understand, that's not entirely up to me.
Oh, thank you, Sheriff. I knew I could count on you to make me whole again. We get it sorted, and I'll be glamour to the nines, I will.
I'm just staring at the glass. That's why I like just one little piece.
Bluebeard, you want to talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean, I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now, but glamours are the law for a very good reason.
Look, I'll take care of it later. I told him we'd work it out so he'd get out of our hair. We don't have time to worry about that right now.
Bigby, what did I tell you?
If he's unglamored when this whole thing is over, I'll send him to the farm. No questions asked, okay?
Fine, we'll deal with it later. I know I should be asking how it got like this, but I just keep wondering why it happened to Faith and Lily. You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with his own hand or if it was one of his goons.
I don't know, but when I catch the fucker who did this, I'll find out why.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
Oh, he got it.
I have to say, I have been better. But thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry, I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
Are you really sure you want to see him?
Probably naked getting tortured.
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
It's the Bloody Mary. Whoa.
What just happened?
We pointed you in the wrong direction. Looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again, okay?
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right. We need to focus on the immediate threat, and that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Are you having trouble with the rhyme, Sheriff?
Mirror, mirror, no time to pout. So where does Crooked Man hang out? recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man symbol on it.
Hold off.
The door. It moves.
Yeah, Jersey mentioned that.
Wait a minute. I know that door.
That's Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. This can't be like it was with Tweedledum. I don't care if it gets out of hand. You don't let it come to that. I know that emotions can run high, and you have your reasons to handle this a certain way.
I'll catch him and bring him back here, alive. Then we can clean him and cook him together.
Good. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against him. So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice.
But soon he mended his evil ways. Oh, is it gonna be? Oh, okay. Dang, it's right under the bridge. What the fuck?
Tim, what the hell are you doing here?
Good evening, Sheriff. I'm here to take you to the boss. Thanks, by the way, for leaving off Tiny.
No.
I have to admit, when they asked me to watch the door, I wasn't sure what to expect when you came through that portal.
Hold on. You've just been waiting for me to show up? You knew I was coming?
That's what they told me. I don't know, they said you made it pretty clear.
Oh, shit.
I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so if you'll come this way. Look, this is the one thing I have to do. Please don't make this hard on me. I don't want to get in trouble.
Fine. Lead on.
Thanks for understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up. I know I'm probably the last person you'd expect to be a guard, or an escort for that matter. I was a little surprised myself when they asked me to do it.
Yeah, you shouldn't be here, Tim. This place is dangerous.
Especially
for someone like you.
It's not like that. Whatever you may think of him, he doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like. He gave me a job, and I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got. Just keep that in mind, maybe? Because if you and the boss go up against each other, the rest of Fabletown is gonna get caught in the middle.
I understand the position you're in, but you don't have to do this. There are other things you could do.
Mm-hmm. So it's just that easy?
Maybe not, but you don't want to be a part of this.
Just
a lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office. But he's there. We need you, but we need him too. What we don't need is a war. Hey, Sheriff, hold up. I gotta go in with you. Can't you just wait up, Sheriff?
I don't have time for this.
God bless us, everyone.
I should wait for him, but no.
Am I some kind of a fucking joke to you? What did I tell you, eh? Stop laughing at me.
Oh, yeah? Mate, I ain't.
Try to wait till he gets here.
It's the wolf I got a problem with.
You needn't worry. He'll come around. And like Crane before.
I'll wait for him.
I'm sure he will prove himself quite handy to have in my pocket. Either he's smart enough to see this is for the best, or dim enough to do as he's told.
I say he'd be more useful killed.
Is he coming?
And made into a rug for me to wipe his shoes on. That bloody monster killed my poor brother.
He's right. He was okay, fine.
Hurry the fuck up, dude.
Things over, but this guy off his leash is a whole other barrel of they're talking crap that shit. I don't want to deal with.
So that's it then. Let's zip the dogs of war. None of you can see fit to stare him down. The best outcome you can picture is having him dead.
Wow.
I'd like to think a little bigger than that. You're not frightened, are you?
What?
Yeah, it's easy for you to say. He didn't pull the claws out on you.
We will tame the wolf, like Crane.
Okay, is he getting louder?
Used to us alive. Well, oh. I don't like it. It's not.
What is he?
Like.
Now you wait.
Yeah.
Excuse me, but I have a job to do.
It took forever. Jeez.
Sheriff Wolf, sir.
Oh, Jersey's in here too? What the fuck? Man, you got the whole squad.
Thank you, Tim. I know the sheriff isn't the accommodating sort, but you handled it. You did well. You can go now.
Thank you, sir.
You see,
Master
everyone
Liberian.
In Fabletown has a role to fill. Right. You just have to pay attention to what they need to help them find it. Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
All right, you got me here. Let's talk.
All right, we'll see what the deal is in the next episode. And we're happy.